I'm going to show you how to make another bracelet for our Delicate Sparkles set. This bracelet does the original units in the focal point of the necklace, and it is the entire bracelet is that are those units. However, they're not laying at a V shape, they're laying next to each other in a linear fashion so that it makes a bracelet instead of a V. Now, when I did this, this one is just a little bit large for my wrist. When I did this, I only left a half an inch open when I made my original units for my length. I should have left an inch open. Then I wouldn't have had, but I thought my embellishments were going to shrink it down. Then I wouldn't have had quite so big of a bracelet. Or if you're going to use clasps instead of a flower, which has to have a loop, which makes more space, or not a flower, but a button, then you can go the full length like I show you. Otherwise, you may want to shorten it just a little bit. But anyway, this is what it looks like. And let me give you a close up on the units. It's really quite pretty. And let's go ahead and look and see what we need to make this little bracelet. Okay, for this project today, you will need 8x6 rondelle crystals. And this is a Chinese crystal. It's half gray and half blue, opaque. And then you will need a 4x3 rondelle crystal. This is a Chinese crystal also. It's half clear and half blue AB. Then you will need 11 OCF beads and 8 OCF beads. And both of these are Tohos, and they are the galvanized aluminum silver tone. You will also need a shank button. Again, I'm going to use the little blue flower button like I did in the last bracelet. And this is just a button I found at Hobby Lobby. You can find a bunch of little cute buttons. Anything you want to use will work, as long as it's a shank button. Then I will be using 10-pound nanofill. You can use 8-pound nanofill or 8-pound fireline. And you can use 6-pound fireline also. You'll just have to sew through your beads more to keep them steady since they're a little larger bead. Okay, so go ahead and put about 2 wingspans of thread onto a size 10 beading needle and we'll get started. Okay, so to begin this project, you will pick up a rondelle, a large one, an 11-0, a small rondelle, an 11-0, a large rondelle, an 11-0, a small rondelle, maybe, and an 11-0, like so. So you will have large and small rondelles alternating with 11-0s in between. Start with a large rondelle, end with a small with a 11-0 seed bead, like so. Bring this down to the end of your thread. You don't have to leave a long tail, just enough to hold on to and make sure your beads don't slip through. And then from the tail side, go back through the first large rondelle that you put on your thread and pull the beads into a circle, like so. Then sew back through all the beads that you put on. When you get all the way around where your tail is coming out of your large rondelle and so is your working thread, then you will go into the first 11-0 seed bead right next to that large rondelle. Tighten your thread and we will begin making little picots on each 11-0. So you'll pick up an 8-0 seed bead, an 11-0 seed bead, and an 8-0 seed bead, like so. You're coming out of this side of the 11-0. You're going to go into the opposite side of the 11-0 and the crystal behind it, or in front of it, whichever way you're looking at it, and pull these beads into a picot between the crystals. Then you'll go into the next 11-0 seed bead. And you'll do the same thing. You'll pick up an 8-0, an 11-0, and an 8-0. And you'll go into the opposite side of the 11-0 you're coming out of and the crystal behind it, like so. Turn your piece, go into the next 11-0. Pick up an 8-0, an 11-0, and an 8-0. And then go into the opposite side of the 11-0 and into the crystal behind it. And pull. And again, go through the next 11-0. Pick up an 8-0, an 11-0, and an 8-0. And go through the 11-0 on the opposite side that you're exiting from, and through the crystal behind it. Like so. And this is what you should have. Now we need to make our next unit. And we want to come out of the beads. We want to come out of the beads here, right underneath the small crystal. So we have to sew through this 11-0 here, the crystal, this 11-0 here, and begin by sewing up into the 11-0 here. So let me show you what I mean. Let's get a little closer. So we're going to go through our original unit by going into the 11-0 we're attached to, the crystal behind it, like so. And then we're going to go through the 11-0 in the original unit underneath the small crystal that we're exiting from here. And then we're going to go into the 8-0 here in the picot to get up to the 11-0 in the picot on the top of it, right here. And then we are going to pick up a large rondelle, an 11-0 seed bead, a small rondelle, an 11-0 seed bead, or excuse me, 11-0 seed bead, large rondelle, 11-0 seed bead, and small rondelle. I'll show you what that looks like, just like that. And then we're coming out of this side of this 11-0, we're going to go into the opposite side of it. And we're going to pull the beads down. Now your crystals, your large crystals, should lay the same way adjacent to each other. So instead of making a V like we did in the necklace portion, we are going to have the rondelles lay the same way. So if you ended up to where your rondelles are coming this way, making a V, then you need to sew through the next unit and make sure that your rondelles are coming out like this. And you will understand what I mean if you make the mistake. But if you follow exactly what I just did, you shouldn't have that problem. Now, we are going to sew through this entire unit. Until we come back through the attaching 11-0 seed bead. Secure it, tighten your tension, then we will sew through the large rondelle to the 11-0 seed bead next to it and exit. Like so. Okay, so we're coming out of the 11-0 seed bead here. We will pick up an 8-0, an 11-0, and an 8-0, and then go into the opposite side of the 11-0 and pull. And then we went through the crystal behind and we're exiting the next 11-0. We will pick up an 8-0 seed bead, an 11-0 seed bead, and an 8-0 seed bead, go into the opposite side of the 11-0 from which we're exiting, and go through the next crystal and pull our thread down, like so. Go into the next 11-0 seed bead here. Pick up an 8-0 and 11-0 and an 8-0. Go into the opposite side of the 11-0 we're exiting from and the crystal behind it. and pull. Make sure your picots lay correctly. And then, let's back off just a little. And then now we're coming out of this little crystal here. We already have a picot here, so we're just going to sew through the connecting 11-0 between the crystals and the crystal behind it. Now we have to get to the same unit in this unit as we did in this unit to begin our next unit. So we will have to sew down to this picot here. We're going to go into our original units to get to it. So we're coming out of the crystal here. We're going to go into the 11-0 and the crystal behind it here in the original unit. And then into the 11-0 underneath that crystal we're exiting from. And then, I've got some thread tangled here, hang on. And then we will go into the 8-0 here. And then into the 11-0 in the corner of the picot, and we'll begin our next unit. We'll do one more on camera, and then we'll continue to length. So what we will do is we will pick up first a large rondelle, an 11-0 seed bead, a small rondelle, an 11-0 seed bead, a large rondelle, an 11-0 seed bead, a small rondelle. Like so. You're coming out of this side of the 11-0. Oops, I lost my rondelle. We'll go into the opposite side of the 11-0 here and pull the beads into a circle. Now we will sew around this entire circle. I'm going to just turn it over so I can get to it better. And I'm going to sew through all the beads I just put on my thread. And then into the connecting 11-0. I'll turn it back over so you can see what I've got. Like so. I'm going to sew through this rondelle and into this first 11-0 here. So I will sew over through this one. Whoops. These picots like to grab the thread. So just be aware of that. And then go through the 11-0 here. Pick up an 8-0. And 11-0 and an 8-0, like so, and go through the opposite side of the 11-0 you're exiting from and the crystal behind it. Pull tight. Again, go through the next 11-0, pick up an 8-0 and 11-0 and an 8-0, and then go through the opposite side of the 11-0 you're exiting from and the crystal behind it. Pull the thread. Make sure everything's laying nicely. Go through the next 11-0 seed bead. Pick up an 11-0 or an 8-0, an 11-0, and an 8-0. Go into the opposite side of the 11-0 and the crystal behind it, and the 11-0 behind it too, if you can get them all at once. So now I'm coming out of the 11-0 connecting my unit. I need to sew, excuse me, I just turned it all over. I need to sew into the rondelle right where I'm exiting. I'm going to turn this back over because it's confusing otherwise. So you always want to make sure you're coming out of the same unit that you have been attaching to. So if you hold your piece the same way all the time, then it'll be easier. If you come out of one of the other units, your beads will not lay nicely next to each other like this. They'll form a V shape, and then you won't be able to make a nice linear design for a bracelet. So then we will go into the 11-0, the crystal, and the 11-0 in the original unit. We will go up through the 8-0 here and into the 11-0 here. And then you will begin your next unit by picking up your crystals and your 11-0s alternating, and do the exact same thing until you have 12 units, or until you reach a half inch short of the length you want. So this is right at 7 inches. I want to make my bracelet a little over 7 inches, about 7.5. So I've left half an inch short, and then I will lose just a tiny bit in my embellishments, not a lot. And then I will add my clasping, which will add my half inch back. So if you want to make a 6 inch bracelet, go to 5.5 inches. If you want to make a 7 inch bracelet, go to 6.5 inches. So this is 12 units and it's 7 inches. Now, I am coming out of this little 11 seed bead here. I'm going to get really close to show you. I've sewn around and got myself back into position to where I would normally go through this 8-0 and this 11-0 and add my next unit, just as we've been doing. However, I'm not going to do that now. I'm coming out of this 11-0, and then I'm going to go down into the rondelle right here. And then I'm going to slide up into this 8-0 here. Now that is off our thread path. Normally we go into this 11-0 here to sew around when you're doing right angle weave. However, I want to kind of pull my bracelet together. So I'm going to go into this 8-0 right here. And then I'm going to go into this 11-0 right next to it. Now let's back off just a little too tight here. And we're going to start an embellishment here. So we're going to pick up a small rondelle crystal, and then we're going to pick up 6 11-0 seed beads. Like this. Okay, we're coming out of this 11-0 seed bead. We're going to skip over this rondelle, over this 8-0, and go into the next 11-0 seed bead in your next picot. Right here. Let me back off again. And then pull these beads through and down. It just makes a little loop like this. Then you will pick up a small rondelle and 6 11-0 seed beads. Like so. I'm coming out of this 11-0. I'm going to skip over all these beads and go into the next 11-0 in the next picot. And then I will pull these beads down. Like so. And we're going to continue doing that the entire length of the bracelet. So a rondelle, 6 11-0s, going to the next 11-0 in the picot, all the way until we get to the end, and we'll be back. Okay, so I have done my entire embellishment, except for the very last one. The very last one is a little different. On the other side, we went through the rondelle, then we went through the 8-0, then the 11-0. But this side is different. The shape of this bracelet, you have to do one side a little bit differently than the other. So let me show you. We are going to do the embellishment exactly the same as we've been doing it on this one, instead of going through the rondelle. So we have our small rondelle and our 6 11-0s on the thread here. And we're going to go ahead and go into the next 11-0 in the picot, like we have been doing through the entire side, like so. Now we need to get over to this little unit here in order to make an attachment for our clasping. So we're going to do that first, and then we'll do the other side of embellishments. So I'm coming out of this 11-0 right here. I'm going to go into this 8-0 right next to it. Now you want to make sure your embellishment is nice all the way down. You've got smooth tension, nothing pulled or bunched, but nothing gapping either. No open spaces. Then go into this little rondelle right next to the 8-0 here. Like so. Get close. Now we're going to sew into the 11-0 in this picot here. At this point, I'm going to cut my tail off. I'll leave a little length so I can burn it down later. Plus, I don't want it to run pull through. This end, we didn't tie a knot. However, we will be securing when we go around to do the other side of embellishment. So go ahead and cut that off. And then you're coming out of this 11-0 here. Go ahead and go up into the 8-0 here. Go into the 11-0 here. And now I'm going to make my attachment for my flower clasp here. So I am going to pick up an 11-0, an 8-0, and then I'm going to go through my button. Let me back off a little. And then I'm going to pick up an 8-0 and an 11-0 and go back through the attaching, the 11-0 that I'm attaching to on the bracelet here. I'm going to pull this down tight. And I'm going to sew through this attachment several times and then we'll be back. Make sure you sew through it at least three, four times, something like that.
Okay, so I have secured my clasping here.
Now I'm coming out of the attaching 11-0 right there.
I'm going to go into this 8-0
right here. Let's get right there.
Go through this 8-0. And then, oh, I got my thread under the other thread here. Hang on. Okay.
Just want to go through this 8-0 right here, and then into this 11-0 here.
If I can get coordinated. Right there.
The one between the crystals on your original unit.
And then go into this rondelle here and the 8-0 behind it.
Now you are going to, I'm going to turn this so that I can hold on to it better. So now we're coming out of the rondelle, the 8-0. We're going to go up into this 11-0 here and we're going to start our embellishments again. So what we're going to do is we are going to pick up a small rondelle and 6 11-0 seed beads. And make sure your embellishment is nice and neat. You're going to notice that this side is going to be a little bit different than this side, and that's just because of the way the bracelet is situated at an angle. So pick up your rondelle and then pick up 6 11-0 seed beads.
Like so, and then go from this 11-0 to this 11-0, skipping over the units, and pull, like so.
Now you will do the same thing you did on the other side, all the way to the end, picking up your rondelle first, then your 6 11-0 seed beads, and going from 11-0 to 11-0 in each picot. And when we get all the way to the end, we'll be back. So I have finished all of my embellishments all the way down the side. So now I have my very last one. I have my rondelle and my 6 11-0 seed beads. And I'm going to skip all over all of these beads and come into this 11-0 on the corner here, in the very last picot here. And now you can see that this corner here is going to be the same as this corner here. This corner here is the same as this corner here. So they are different on either side here, but they're the same on both sides if you look at it as a whole bracelet. So that, if that makes sense. But the way, like I said, this is laying at an angle, I really didn't have much of a choice but to do it that way. So that's how I did it. So now we are going to come into... So we're coming out of this 11-0 here after putting our last embellishment on. We're going to go into this 8-0 here.
Make sure your embellishment is tight all the way across. Nothing is bagging and nothing is twisted, and just all the way across, because this is where you're going to secure this entire embellishment. And then you're going to go into this rondelle right here and the 11-0 after it. So let's get real close. So we're going to go through these two middle beads here. So you're coming out of the 8-0, you're going to go into the rondelle, and then you're going to go into the 11-0 in the opposite picot right here. So now I'm coming out of this 11-0 here. I'm going to sew up into this 8-0 and then into this 11-0 here. So I'm going to turn this, go up into this 8-0, turn my bracelet, then up into the 11-0. Make sure that your corner is not bunched or funny, because this end kind of comes up in a corner like this side did over here. And we are going to make a loop here to attach around our flower, our bead, not our button. I can't talk. Not everybody has the same button, so we can't do exactly the same thing. What we're going to do is, I'm going to make sure this still fits around my wrist well. It does. So I am going to pick up, let me see if I want to put a little crystal embellishment on that. I think I could. If you want to, you can put a little crystal and then come up through it. But I think what I'm going to do is just make a circle here. So I'm just going to pick up, I'm going to pick up an 11-0, a crystal, like this, and then I'm going to pick up as many 11-0s as it takes to go around my button. So I'm going to just pick up a series of them until I think I have enough, and then I will test it, and I'll show you how to test it. So I'm just going to continue picking up 11-0s and dropping them down to that crystal. A few more. And then once I have as many 11-0s as I think I need, I'm going to come through this crystal right here. And just the crystal, not the 11-0 underneath it. If I can do that. Now, I don't think that's going to fit around my bead. There's no way that's going to fit around my button. So I'm going to pick up a few more, and then I will pull through the crystal here, hold it tight, and test it until I get enough. Once I get enough and I know it'll go around my flower bead or button, I'll be back. Okay, so I believe I have enough beads now. So I'm coming out of my crystal. I put as many beads around there as I thought that I needed, and then I went through my crystal. And now I'm going to pick up an 11-0 seed bead, and I'm going to go back through the seed bead on the opposite side where I started and connected my crystal and my loop to. So now I'm going to go through that with my 11-0, like so. And then I'm going to sew back up through all of my beads in my circle a couple of times, and then come back down through my connecting bead and secure this. Once I have done that, I'll be back. Okay, so I have sewn around and secured my loop several times. And as I did this, when I came back up through my crystal and through all of my beads and back down through my crystal, then through the 11-0 on this side underneath it, then I came through this little picot here. I'd come through this 11-0 here, and then go around the entire picot, and then back up through my loop. So I'm going to show you what I did. I would come down through this one, then I'd sew through this picot here. So I go through this 8-0, this 11-0, connecting here, and this 8-0 here. Back up through this 11-0, and then I would go back up into my loop. So each time you secure your loop, make sure you secure this picot here too, because that will pull out too. This is the part of the bracelet that's going to get tugged on a lot. So now I have gone through mine several times, so I'm not going to try to go up through it again. I'm coming out of this 8-0 here. I am going to grab a half hitch knot, right on the thread bridge there. And I'm going to go back through this 11-0 here. And down into this 8-0 here. Into the 11-0 between the crystals. It's getting a little thread tight now. I've sewn through it a few times. So I'm going to pull that through. Go down into this rondelle here. And the 8-0 and the crystal. In my work here, and I'm just going to cut off my thread, and I'm going to get a lighter and blob down a little knot there so it doesn't slip through my beads. Tug it in, and I'll show you what this looks like, and I'll show you what it looks like on the wrist. Now, this is probably going to be a little long. When you make your original units, you can leave an inch, or you don't have to have this little crystal here either. You could go straight through the 11-0 and the top of the pico, and that would shorten the bracelet some too. So I'm going to test and see what I've got as far as length on my bracelet. And it also depends on how loose you like your bracelet, so it may be just about right. Actually, it's not bad. It's a little loose. I could have probably left an inch instead of a half an inch, but it's not too terrible. It moves around on my wrist some, but it won't fall off my hand. So if you want it to be a little shorter, like I said, you don't have to have the crystal here. You can go straight through the 11-0. That will help with a little bit of length. And you can also leave an entire inch when you make your length of your original units, leave an inch open instead of a half an inch. So let's look at it and see what it looks like. It's actually very pretty. And I hope you enjoyed this video and you have fun making the bracelet. Bye-bye.